Democracy won in Jammu and Kashmir, and that's the big takeaway. Let's take you through the big takeaways of verdict in Jammu and Kashmir. Number one, it's the BJP's best ever show in Jammu and Kashmir. It's Mission 44 plus flopped. The Modi wave failed to win voters in the Kashmir Valley. The BJP has made inroads in Muslim majority areas of Jammu. This is the National Conference's worst ever performance since independence. The Congress Party, on the other hand, has done better than expected in Jammu and Kashmir. The face saver for the Congress is that it's the only party to have won seats in Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh, in all the three regions. Now, Omar Abdullah may be down, but he's certainly not out. The outgoing chief minister of Jammu and Kashmir, Omar Abdullah, spoke on the party's defeat in these elections. He spoke exclusively to Headlines Today's Moshmi Singh. He conceded that the state floods, the execution of Afzal Guru, these were some of the aspects that worked against him. On a possible alliance with the BJP, he made an important point. He said he's not going to reach out to anyone, but he's willing for others to speak to him. There are no permanent enemies in politics, he said.
We have with us Mr. Omar Abdullah live, and we speak to him. Sir, the results, how do you see them with the amount of anticipation, the clear fight this time? How do you anticipate and interpret the results?
Well, I am extremely satisfied with the way things have gone. I know we haven't won, but I think all things considered, we've put up a very credible performance. Please understand that at the beginning of the campaign, there is hardly anybody who was willing to give us more than 5 to 7 seats.
That's right.
Today I have 15 plus 2 independents that I've supported. So I think with everything that has gone wrong recently, particularly the floods and everything else, the whole Modi factor and all considered, if I have 17 MLAs today, we are a very serious player in whatever scenario will unfold now.
So, sir, if you see that many were writing you off completely, you're still an important player. Are you keeping your options open? Are you looking at PDP? Are you looking at BJP? What are the options in front of you?
I'm not approaching anybody. But that doesn't stop anybody from approaching me. I have kept whatever options. I've not closed any option. But I'm not going to be picking up the phone and calling anybody. I'm not desperate for power. I have governed this state for 6 years. I am the last person who will go desperately seeking office now. I have time on my side. I'm 44. The next time the elections come about, I'll only be 50.
So you're saying you're not going to seek for government formation and trying to work out the permutations and combinations?
I'm not working out any combinations. I know that there are a number of different combinations. There are combinations that make us a party or a player, but I'm not exploring any options. I'm not calling anybody. If anybody wants to talk to me, I have no problem.
The Congress Party is talking about the Grand Alliance, keeping the BJP out and getting you and the PDP on the same board. How do you weigh that?
That would probably be my least preferred option. It's not an option I'm interested in. If the Congress wants to be a part of government formation, they can do it on their own. They shouldn't talk to me.
And what about the BJP? It was untouchable at some point of time because you had a four-cornered contest.
I'm not going to get into specifics. As I said, I'm not picking up the phone to call anybody. That having been said, if somebody speaks to me, my colleagues and I will talk about it.
The PDP has gone into a huddle. They have been having this series of meetings and they have sent feelers to the BJP trying to appreciate the Prime Minister. So do you think that it would be fair for them to come together with the BJP just to give a stable government?
Anything is possible. I think the onus is on the PDP and the BJP to decide first what they want to do. The National Conference, as I said, we are very satisfied with the way things have gone. Obviously, we would have preferred a few more seats, but all things considered, I'm not at all disheartened by the results.
But do you think that the people of Jammu and Kashmir have, in turn, with all that went wrong and you had a difficult tenure, they've still imposed some faith in you in the way your party has performed?
Well, certainly. I mean, if you think of everything that went wrong in these last 6 years, the agitation of the floods aside, the agitation of 2010, the execution of Afzal Guru, the floods just a few months ago. If after all this, I still have 17 MLAs and I myself am an elected representative in this house, I think I have a lot to be grateful for.
But then again, if it's a hung assembly and they have given you the numbers they have, don't you think that you should be making that effort to come into the government and do justice to the faith that the people have given you?
The onus is not on me. There are two parties that have more MLAs than I do, the PDP and the BJP. I think the onus is first on them to explore options, not on me.
You said you won't pick up the phone, but if you get a phone call from the BJP, for example, Amit Shah has said that he's keeping his options open. NC is not ruled out. If they extend the hand, would you hold it?
Let's not get into ifs or buts. There has been no contact. When there is, we'll see.
Okay. And the PDP?
As I said, there's been no contact, so we'll see what happens.
Will we see two local parties, the regional parties, getting together?
Look, I think this is a question for Mufti Sahab, not for me. I have my MLAs and I'm sitting tight. We'll see what happens.
Any word for him, for his performance in this election? Would you like to say something?
Honestly, I expected him to do better. With everything, the floods and all, I think the PDP has more reason to be dissatisfied than I do. I always knew it was a tough election for me. I'm extremely satisfied with the performance that the National Conference has put in. I think somewhere lurking inside, the PDP is going to be deeply disappointed with their performance.
One last question. Sir, I would like to ask that when you were fighting the elections, from the PDP to the BJP to the Prime Minister himself, it was a four-cornered contest. Now the PDP is looking to make alliance. They're sending out feelers. Do you think it is fair to the voters, because you fought elections against each other and now you come after the results are out, you become foes become friends?
That's electoral politics. That's what democracy is all about. I mean, in 2002, the PDP and the Congress fought elections against each other. In 2008, the National Conference and the Congress fought elections against each other. But we formed a post-poll alliance. And therefore, if a post-poll alliance emerges out of this, I don't think the people want governor's rule. Governor's rule would probably be the least preferred option, and therefore, if you ask the voters of Jammu and Kashmir, would they rather a government or governor's rule? I think you'll get your answer, and therefore, like I said, I think the onus is on the BJP and the PDP first to explore whatever options they want to explore.
That is a very candid Omar Abdullah, where he's saying, "I have a lot to be grateful for." Afzal Guru was hanged. There was devastating floods in Jammu and Kashmir. And despite that, he's got 15 plus 2. He says, "I have a lot to be grateful for. I will not pick up the phone and make the calls, but I'm willing to receive calls and willing to talk to everyone. Nobody's an enemy in politics." What went against him? Well, there was criticism of rehabilitation post the Jammu and Kashmir floods. Omar Abdullah's perceived disconnect with voters cost him. His critics claim he isn't people-friendly enough. The mutual decision between the National Conference and the Congress to split ahead of the state elections, it may have worked against the BJP. It did not benefit Omar much either. The lack of development and unemployment, said to be the highest in the country, went against Omar Abdullah. People still haven't forgiven him for not taking speedy action in the 2010 fake encounter case. Also, the Shopian case. Now, there were thousands of people who were out on the streets. Lastly, the absence of National Conference patron Farooq Abdullah. He underwent an operation recently. Now, he was seen as a star campaigner. This is seen as something that went against him. Also, Mehboob Beg's decision to split is being cited as one of the reasons for the debacle. They've emerged as the single largest party in Jammu and Kashmir. Mehbooba Mufti spoke to journalists just a short while back. She's indicated they may seek support. They may take BJP's support. PDP chief Mehbooba Mufti thanked the NDA government for peaceful elections in Jammu and Kashmir. She insisted they're keeping all options open. Nothing is off the table.
चले फिर शुरू करें
जी मैडम जी
हम बहुत शुक्रगुजार हैं जम्मू कश्मीर के लोगों के जिन्होंने आज हमें वोट देके जो सबसे लार्जेस्ट पार्टी के बतौर हमें चुना है। इसके साथ जो यहाँ की स्टेट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन है, हम उनके भी बहुत शुक्रगुजार हैं जिस तरह से उन्होंने इलेक्शन कंडक्ट किया। स्टेट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन हो, पुलिस डिपार्टमेंट हो, इलेक्शन कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया हो, या फॉर दैट मैटर इवन जो दिल्ली में एनडीए की सरकार है, जो जिस किस्म के यहाँ फ्री एंड फेयर इलेक्शन हुए उसके लिए हम बहुत शुक्रगुजार हैं। जम्मू कश्मीर के लोगों के बहुत शुक्रगुजार हैं कि हम एक जो सिंगल लार्जेस्ट पार्टी बन के सामने आए हैं। हालांकि ये जो मैंडेट है, इट इज़ नॉट अ डिसाइसिव मैंडेट नहीं है, और शायद हमारी एक्सपेक्टेशन के मुताबिक भी नहीं है। जितना हम एक्सपेक्ट कर रहे थे उतना ज़्यादा हमें जो है इसमें कामयाबी हासिल नहीं हुई है। तो अब चूंकि सरकार बनाने की बात है, सो आर एफर्ट विल बी, हमारी जो प्रायोरिटी होगी वो ये नहीं होगी कि हम किसी तरह से इसे जोड़ तोड़ से, या वी डोंट वांट टू कॉबल अप अ गवर्नमेंट, बट डेफिनेटली कि वी आर लुकिंग फॉर अ काइंड ऑफ अ गवर्नेंस विच इज़ बेस्ड ऑन आवर एजेंडा, जो हमने लोगों के सामने अपना एजेंडा रखा है गुड गवर्नेंस का और बाकी चीज़ें। एंड इट्स गोइंग टू टेक टाइम टू डेलिब्रेट एंड एक्सप्लोर कि कौन सी ऐसी फॉर्मेशंस हैं जहां हम जम्मू कश्मीर के लोगों की एस्पिरेशंस को अकोमोडेट करते हुए लोगों को जो एक्सपेक्टेशंस हमसे हैं गुड गवर्नेंस की, पॉलिटिकल प्रोसेस को आगे ले जाने की, तो उस फॉर्मेशन में कौन सा फॉर्मेशन बनेगा अभी वो बताना बड़ा मुश्किल है। विल टेक आवर टाइम, क्योंकि आपको याद है 2002 में हमारी 16 सीटें थी, और बच्चों की उस वक्त जो अगेन एक क्रेडिबिलिटी क्राइसिस था, जो नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस की सरकार थी, लोगों ने खिलाफ वोट दिया था, और आज भी जो है बहुत एनसीएन कांग्रेस के खिलाफ लोगों ने वोट दिया और हम एक बड़ी पार्टी बन के उभर आए हैं। सो वी आर गोइंग टू डेलिब्रेट एंड एक्सप्लोर द पॉसिबिलिटीज की क्या फॉर्मेशन हो सकती है जिसमें लोगों की, जम्मू कश्मीर के लोगों की एस्पिरेशंस मीट करें, एंड एट द सेम टाइम जो हमारा एजेंडा है, हमारा पॉलिटिकल प्रोसेस आगे चलाने का, हमारा गुड गवर्नेंस का, तो सो विल टेक आवर टाइम, वी आर नॉट इन अ हरी। थैंक यू सो मच
मैडम। टू फिल अप द नंबर्स यू नीड सपोर्ट ऑफ ईदर कांग्रेस और बीजेपी। Where are you going? Please tell us.
I told you that we are not, you know, there to cobble up any numbers just for the sake of arithmetic. See, we had a common minimum program in 2002 and it worked very good for us and it worked very good for the country also. Is waqt bhi hamara jo is waqt jo priority hai, that is not to cobble up a government. It is to, you know, to explore the possibilities koi कि ऐसा कौन सी formations बनाए जिससे जो PDP का agenda है, जो हमारे लोगों से।
Let's now talk about the BJP. It's emerged as the party with the largest vote share in Jammu and Kashmir. It's increased its tally from 11 in 2008 now to 25 in 2014. And Amit Shah, the BJP president, the man who led this audacious Mission 44, he's celebrating. The Mission 44 may not have succeeded, but he says BJP is now a force to reckon with in Jammu and Kashmir. Let's listen in.
सारे विकल्प खुले हैं, बीजेपी की सरकार बनाने का विकल्प भी खुला है, किसी को समर्थन देने का भी विकल्प खुला है, और किसी की सरकार में शामिल होने का भी विकल्प खुला है। तीनों विकल्प खुले हैं, भारतीय जनता पार्टी बाकी की पार्टियां जो इनिशिएटिव लेगी इसके आधार पर निर्णय करेगी।
एंड प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी हु विजिटेड जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एवरी मंथ सिंस ही टुक ओवर इंक्लूडिंग ऑन दिवाली, ही ट्वीटेड, record turnout in Jammu and Kashmir polls show people's faith in democracy. I thank them from the bottom of my heart for placing their confidence in the BJP. People of Jharkhand have voted for stability, which is essential to realize the true potential of the state. I congratulate them. My congratulations to the BJP karyakartas of Jharkhand and Jammu and Kashmir. The results are the outcome of their hard work and selfless dedication. So was there a Narendra Modi wave in Jammu and Kashmir, and was there a Modi wave in Jharkhand? What do results indicate? Let's find out. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, the BJP star campaigner, seems to have hit the mark in Jammu and Kashmir, putting the party within striking distance of forming a government, something that was unthinkable even a year ago. In Jharkhand, the wave was not as big as the BJP had hoped. A government formation is certain. Of course, they will have to take support of allies. Interestingly, the bigger victory for Narendra Modi's in Jammu and Kashmir The fact that the BJP has emerged as the party with the single largest vote share, and that's 23.4% vote share. The PDP, the single largest party, has 22% vote share. The BJP had the largest vote share, emerging as the largest vote gatherer in Jammu and Kashmir.
जम्मू कश्मीर का सवाल है. 2008 के चुनाव में बीजेपी के पास 11 सीटें थी. आज हम 25 सीटों पर बढ़त बना ली है या तो हम जीत चुके हैं. मतलब 14 सीटों की बढ़ोतरी जम्मू कश्मीर के अंदर हमने की है. और सबसे बड़ी आनंद की बात भारतीय जनता पार्टी के लिए है कि जम्मू कश्मीर में भारतीय जनता पार्टी सर्वाधिक वोट प्राप्त करने वाली पार्टी बनी है. परसेंटेज वाइज भारतीय जनता पार्टी को सबसे ज़्यादा वोट जम्मू कश्मीर में मिले हैं. अब तक के जो आंकड़े उपलब्ध है उसमें भारतीय जनता पार्टी 23.4% वोट पाई है और उसके बाद में पीडीपी 22% के आसपास वोट पाई है.
मोदी साहब जो है ये मुल्क में जो मैंडेट मिला बीजेपी को उनकी वजह से मिला, जम्मू में भी जो मैंडेट मिला उनकी वजह से मिला. और मेरी जाती राय है कि वो इंसाफ करना चाहते हैं. ये जो लोग कहते हैं कि वो 370 खत्म कर देंगे, मुसलमानों को माइनॉरिटी बना देंगे, ये खाम खा का प्रोपेगेंडा है.
भाजपा विरोधी मत बिखरा हुआ है कई हिस्सों में और वैसी परिस्थिति में तो कम वोट पर भी उनको अपने आप स्पष्ट बहुमत मिलना चाहिए था. और जिस ढंग का रुझान था उसके हिसाब से तो ऐसा लगता था कि उनको स्वीप करना चाहिए, लेकिन ये हालात दिख नहीं रहे हैं. तो ये